nice and smooth.
Yeah, lots of sanding going on. Turns out, after watching a bunch of Paint Society videos on YouTube, I suddenly had the confidence to paint this thing myself. And here I am, sanding down to gel coat. I figure once I get to this stage, no problem. I just gotta prime it, then I can sand it down like I did that other stuff in the back there. So, I've got a lot of paint to do, but I'm figuring I'm working on the white stuff first. Give me the confidence to actually move down the sides here. So I'm just working on the last bit of paint on, or the white, old white paint on the roof, and then I can go to prime. Fortunately, we have a nice sunny day today, but we have a whole week of rain ahead of us. But if it rains on the primer, that's fine, right? Because then I'm technically wet sanding. So yeah, let's keep sanding and we'll get her done. Yeah. Sanding is awesome, said no one ever.
Wah wah. Wah wah wah. What is that? Damn it! I only got a little bit left, and sure enough, I ran out. Wah 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 wah. Excuse me, coming through. Well, that was a full day.
All right, so last night I was able to paint the hood of the Chevarello finally. I was so excited I ran out here this morning to check out my quality work in my awesome paint shop here. And it actually turned out not so bad. So I'm pretty happy with this. You see, I don't know if you can see it, it's a little orange peely in the reflection there, but I'm kind of not even too worried about that. Maybe I'll try sanding it out and see how it works, but the part I didn't expect were these guys to show up. We've had so many caterpillars this year, and I guess they're turning into moths now, damn it. So, yeah, this guy might still be alive, I think. He's not moving, but he's probably stuck down pretty good. I'll see if I can take a knife and cut his wings and, separate him from the panel. I'm actually not too worried about this because this part here will remain white like in the coach, but on the original paint job, this will be silver. So I'll sand this back down and go to silver, and this might go to blue, but I didn't realize it was going to be a moth magnet. Anyway, makes me wonder how I'm going to paint the rest of the coach if I don't want moths sticking to it. But again, maybe I don't even care. I'll just paint it. We'll figure it out when the time comes. But not bad for the Harbor Freight cheapest paint gun I could find. So let's keep doing it. It's time, buddy. Let's get you off of there. We're doing all right. We're doing all right. We're good. Oh, yeah.
It's my turn to operate.
Operate?
Butterfingers!
It's Operation the Wacky Doctor's
Here's
Game.
Your car.
Batteries not included.
All right. We can do this.
Takeout is spare it for $100.
Oh, you'll never do that.
Don't touch the side.
Here goes his funny bone.
It takes a very steady hand.
I did it. That's $200 for me.
Now don't go out and get hit by a vehicle now.
May I play?
Operation, a Milton Bradley game.
You got one leg. Sorry, buddy. Oh. You good? Yeah, he's perfect. All right, so I've been trying to get the front lights out of here, but it looks like the flathead screws that hold the headlight trim ring have rusted off completely. So you got little stubs there, but not enough for me to actually turn. So I can't get the grinder in there. I can't get a die grinder in there to get the headlight ring off. I can't undo the adjusting screws, because then the springs are still holding it in place. So I'm like, I think the only thing left to do is to hammer it out and then get the angle grinder in there to get rid of the headlight trim ring, get a new trim ring later on, and then I can actually pull the headlight out. So let's bust some headlights. There we go. It's one way to change your headlights. Now, I can get the headlights out. All right. Yeah. Oh, so you don't want to come out either. Next. All right, behold the moth-free paint booth. So I'm running out of daylight. It's 8 o'clock, loose sun at 9, got a lamp. Let's get this thing painted. It's all nice and sanded back, all the way up, contained within a tent. What can possibly go wrong? So let's get mixing some paint and start spraying. Pretty much it. That was 1 quart of paint on that one coat. I guess I vastly underestimated how much paint I would actually use on it, but from what I can tell, it actually looks pretty good. So the bugs are already starting to land in it, but look, you see a moth? See them? Get out of here. Anyway, hopefully it won't land in it. I built this thing. Get out of here. All right, he won't be back to bother us. So hopefully no moss landing in it. And now we wait. It's supposed to be dry tonight, humid but dry, and then tomorrow in the afternoon it rains all day. So please don't rain on it. Would you look at that? God damn it. I built this so you wouldn't get stuck in there, for fuck's sakes. Damn it. Thanks, pal. You know, you try to help these guys out, build a tent so they can't move in, and they move in. Come here. Gotcha. Now out with you. All right. Better be the last of them. All right, my moth, anti-moth tent sort of kind of worked. I still got 2 moth hits though, but overall I am super stoked with the way that came out. This is only 1 coat of single stage white. I just ran out of paint. I didn't anticipate how much I would need on this actually, but it was getting kind of late and I think I laid it on kind of heavy, but I got 1 run right there. But I'm pretty stoked with the way all this turned out actually. You did see this one. I got 2 bug hits. I got this one moth here, the witch lit, starting to look suspiciously like a Firebird logo to me now. And then the one on the nose over here. But this nose section here will be going silver all the way across, and the mouth section will be blue eventually. So, but I think the parts that are, get out of here, moth. But I think the sections that are white are pretty good. And now I can actually go ahead and install the front windows. So yeah, let's get this thing unbagged and see what it looks like in the light. See if there is any thin spots in there. I am chuffed. All right, day 2 in the Moth Mahal, or paint number 2 in the Moth Mahal. So last night I did the silver and I'm pretty happy with the way that looks. I didn't get like any orange peeling. I got a couple little, one of the fish eyes in there. I guess I didn't prep that well enough, but I don't really care about that. Also got the hood done as well. What I don't like is this, the contrast. So I picked a silver that was really bright, and it sort of worked best with this. I mean, you could barely even tell the difference between this and the paint chip. And then when I sprayed it, it looks like this. So that's two coats of the single stage on there with a white base. I don't know what's going on. Maybe I gotta get it in the sun, because if I look at the hood over there, the way it's reflecting the light, it kind of looks like that. So I don't know what's going on there yet. Who'd have thought this painting stuff would be so hard? All right, so second coat of silver. See, it still doesn't quite line up. Yeah, so learning lots about silver paint these days, but that, after looking online and a couple recommendations from friends, they said, look at Switchblade Silver from GM. It's like the new Camaro color. It's pretty bright silver. So I've taken a chance, I've ordered another quart of that. So I'm gonna sand this back and then paint it again. They said I'm really making it smooth now. Haven't had this flavor yet. Kind of tangy. Anyway, so third paint job of silver is now on. I can tell that it's not 100%, but it's a lot better than the last one. So got a couple of minutes before I do a second coat right now. It's not looking bad, except for that one bug who walked across this one and got off. That little guy there, and a moth that landed there. Why do we even bother putting up this tent? Doesn't even make sense. Anyway, round two coming up. All right, look how glorious this paint is. I am really stoked with how that turned out. But it's okay, so now that that's painted, I can install the glass. I still have to paint the mouth, probably the blue color like it was originally, but I don't want to do that until I take the engines, or take the old one out and put the new one in, because I'm sure I'm going to bounce something off of the paint at some point and come up with a cool bumper and stuff. But while I am thinking about painting and getting this stuff done, let's just do the back end of it as well. So same thing on the back. I gotta strip it right back down to the green, as you can see where all the cracks in the paint, it's been damaged and cracked. So I gotta repair some fiberglass and get this thing painted. I don't know if I've ever showed you guys this. So this is the trailer hitch, right? It's kind of sketchy, right? It's on some sort of pivot. Why is it on a pivot, you may ask? Because of this. This is the ultra sketchy part. Push a button, open it up, and the trailer hitch goes down as well. So that's where the spare wheel was kept. But I don't trust that trailer hitch, considering the only thing holding that trailer hitch up is that little clasp. Anyway, so not even sure what's going to happen here. I'm obviously not going to keep the trailer hitch, and I probably won't carry a spare back here, but I might cut this out and make it an entry into the underneath the bed or something like that. Anyway, TBD on that one. In the meantime, let's get this stripped back, prime, painted white. We'll do the silver. Then I gotta figure out what color blue I'm gonna use here, because I dig that tone blue, whatever it is, that sort of a, I don't know, semi metallic blue. And then I can reinstall the rear glass, change the lights, fix these lights, etc., etc., etc. And then I get to move on to the mechanical parts, repair the underneath and swap the motor, right? That should be the fun part. That's the easy part. I had no idea what I was doing when I came to paint, but I think I got a pretty good grasp now. So let's keep going. All right, so I've been working on the back of the coach for the past couple days. You're just sanding and doing repairs to all the fiberglass and whatnot and the cracks, but since I've had so much time to think about it, I've been wondering about the spare wheel hole. I'm not going to be carrying a spare wheel in there in the traditional way that this coach was built, using this flappy thing to hold the wheel, because it's kind of inconvenient. But I do think using this circle would be a good idea to actually access the inside of the coach underneath the beds. Well, they'll have all that storage facility, just because we don't have a traditional style door on the side of the coach by which we can open it up. What do you think?
I'm thinking we just cut that center hole that was used for the spare tire out and just be able to crawl in and out, put things in.
But what if we cut it square? So we could use this line here too, as opposed to the round.
I don't know, I kind of like the tube. It's like a Jeffrey's tube from Star Trek.
Alright. This is kind of spacey, shippy, boaty. So, alright, let's do with the Jeffrey's tube. I'm into that. If we don't like it, we can always make it square, but we can at least start with a circle.
Yeah.
Alright, let's get cutting. Alright, so second opinion. We got two options here, Mom. And that's, I need an access hatch in the back of the RV, right? So rather than cutting a door on the side like other RVs have, I have two options. I know how I voted, I know how Dutch voted, but we can either cut out the circle or we can cut it out square.
Well, I'm gonna assume you guys went for the circle. What are you accessing? Like, do you have to put square stuff in there?
No, the biggest thing that'll probably go through there will be one of us.
What's on the other side of it?
It'll be the underside of the bed frame. So that's just open storage all the way inside, as far up as the bed frame is.
Well, I'm gonna assume you won't like my practical response, but I'm just thinking, if you're coming with boxes and stuff, you would have more access space if you made it square.
But square is not cool. It's square, man. If we don't like the circle, we can always go out to the rectangle or the square. But I think starting with the circle and looking at it...
Nobody's going to see it because there's this hatch thing over top of it anyway, right? Or it's the fact that you know it's there.
What do they call the tubes in Star Trek?
Jeffrey's tubes. Took me a second. Okay.
It'd be like our own Jeffrey's tube.
That's often where people die. On Star Trek.
Just don't wear a red shirt.
Fine. All right.
I'm still going red. I mean, I'm still going round for now.
Great Scott!
All right, so the whole back of the coach has been sanded back down to 220, but before I go any further, let's address the Jeffrey's tube cover. And that's this piece here. I know for sure I'm not going to use this trailer hitch pivot assembly, and I'm not going to be carrying a spare wheel back here anymore. So I think I'm going to cut all the metal out of that, which will make it considerably lighter. And then I'll probably end up, I guess, probably putting some sort of hinge across the top. Don't know what kind of hinge yet. And then definitely putting some gas struts just to hold it up when I do need access to the whatever's gone wrong inside the Jeffrey's tube that you can only access through the Jeffrey's tube. So let's strip this out, get it sanded, get it primed and sanded again, and then so we can paint the white at the same time. Alright, I'm pretty much good for paint. It's all sanded back down to 400 and I spent the last hour papering it off. And then I decided to look at the weather. Unfortunately, it's calling in 2 hours. We got a 50% chance of rain. And when I look up now, I got some big clouds moving in. So there could be a potential. Plus the winds are picking up. So as much as I want to paint right now, I don't think I'm going to. It's not like I'm driving it tomorrow anyway. I don't mind repainting it again, but I don't want to sand it again, you know? That stuff sucks. All right, holding pattern. Yeah, well, good thing I waited. Start to see the rain coming in now. But I think I'm going to build a tarp cover just to protect the paper, if nothing else right now. Here comes the rain. Oh,
head like a memory.
All right, rain or shine, it's time to paint this thing. Hopefully no bugs find it, but guaranteed, as soon as there's fresh paint on there, every bug in the neighborhood's gonna find it. Anyway, let's get painting.
All right, so
the blue tarp is gonna cast a hell of a weird shadow on the white as I'm painting it. Hopefully I can see what's going on.
Toot toot. Gonna go paint the hatch door now.
All right, so it only spittled a little bit, but I'm glad I put the cover on anyway. So I'm pretty happy with the way this turned out, except for that giant run right there. I was really trying to lay it on heavy across this ledge when I was up on the ladder, but I didn't realize what I was doing on the front side of that. So I'll have to figure out how to sand that off and smooth that out a little bit. But I may have a plan for the upper section here, but TBD. But the bottom section, which will remain white, is fabulous. Yeah, I'm not sure if I'm gonna do that blue or not, like the original one. Yeah, the white on the bottom is fantastic. Got all up in there, it looks great. I'll be happy when I can take the blue tarp off so I can get a much better look at it. And the Jeffries tube cover is sitting over here and it looks pretty good as well. I think the white seems to go on much better than some other colors. I got a couple of leaves starting to fall in, but I won't worry about those till when it's all dry and I'll get a knife on it and pick those off. Either way, so looking forward to doing the silver, but of course I gotta wait till this is fully dry now, so hurry up. Reminds me of all those model kits you're building when you're a kid and you're like, can't wait to put it together, so all of the paint's wet, you're putting it back together. Yeah. Can't do that. You can hear that or not. That's the rain coming down. But I think this thing's now dry enough that even if it does rain, like I can touch and not leave my fingerprint, but it's still definitely soft. So I think that's just in time. Yeah, this will be fun. Yeah, that'll be fine. All right, do your worst. Not really, just kidding.
Well, after a night of extreme thunderstorms, lots of rain and hail, I probably shouldn't have tempted the universe to do your worst. Anyway, so obviously all the paper blew off, but I think this is completely fine. This thing was, looked at the window at one point and I think I saw the whole A-frame moving over, so either way, it's not leaning against the coach and we're all good. So this has actually turned out pretty good, so I can touch it, this is fine. Let's get this ripped off.
All right, I got the silver done last night and I gotta say, this is really nice. This is the smoothest paint I've laid down yet. Like, you can't stare at the sun or anything, but there's like no orange peel going on and it's so smooth. There's one little bug hit, looks like he was trying to crawl out of there, but this is good looking stuff. Let's rip the paper off, have another look at it.
Well, that's a new lesson. Make sure the tape is stuck down properly. Dang it, I'll have to figure out how to sand that out.
All right, so I got all the white sanded down and it's pretty darn smooth. So taking a look at the side of the coach, you see that it's two-tone blue. Well, it's kind of faded. It's kind of like a turquoise and a dark blue, whatever, somewhere in there. It's kind of more green than blue, right? Anyway, I want to bring this coach back to blue, but I want to do similar scheme, but light blue, dark blue. And this section was the same color as the bottom of the coach. So my original plan was to do this in like a heavy bass boat metal flake. But after watching a lot of YouTube videos on how to paint metal flake, I think that's sort of out of the question. So I got like three layers of paint, three layers of metal flake, three layers of candy, and then that's a whole painting technique in itself. And then sanding and then more clear on top of that. To do the whole coach in that, I think it's too much. So I just looked around and got the biggest metal flake in blue that I can for now. It's not as sparkly as I want. You know, when you picture bass boat, you picture heavy drum kit metal flake, right? This just sort of looks like a shiny Volkswagen or something. Anyway, let's try this out. Maybe if you guys have a suggestion for even bigger metal flake. I looked at the Avery stuff and the 3M stuff, and neither of them are very good. Hopefully there's another brand out there I can find. But this is a nice small panel, so I'm gonna try it here first. Never wrapped before. So I'm not gonna time lapse this, because this will probably be, I don't know, a couple of days or something. I think the biggest issue I'll have is probably trying to shrink it into these corners, maybe. I don't know. Anyway, when you see me again, it'll be done. All right, so I'm not gonna say I'm happy with the quality of my work here. It was a very steep learning curve in this one, and there's mistakes on almost all of it, but it is a nice blue. I think if I can get another blue metallic, I'll probably end up doing it again, something with a heavier metal flake. This is a learning experience, let's put it that way. I even got, you can see right in the center here, I ended up having to cut this because I had all sorts of bunching material and I didn't know what to do with it all. I ended up cutting here, cutting it in the top. But piece of the protective film got caught underneath of this sticky part, and I can see it now trapped underneath the center there. So I'll have to, I don't know, put a sticker there or something. Yeah, so moving forward, I'll probably get the window in here and then I'll start working on the framework finally. Man, that stuff looks great when the sun's making it pop. It's pretty cool. I installed the taillights yesterday. I had to, just to see the contrast. I love it when all the new stuff starts coming together and sort of get a better picture of it. It's also interesting how the blue sort of looks like the original Chevy logo, which goes on the hatch cover and the nose piece there. I'm digging this. In fact, it's kind of funny. You can see the contrast between what we've done there on the new stuff and then the old dingy side of it on from the 70s. Eventually, this upper blue color will be the entire length down here, and then I need to come up with a lighter blue metallic up top or another color, undetermined yet. But you see how I put an extra piece of blue wrap on the lower side there, and it's not popping as much as this side. And I wonder if I have to paint that base white first. I have to still do some work on this side of the coach anyway, so I'm going to prime it and maybe go to Fleet White, hoping that'll pop. Incidentally, you can see that hole that I punched in there with the car. It's pretty much gone. You can't even tell it was there. And yeah, so if anybody else out there knows what this stuff is, I cannot remove this stuff. This stuff is a pain. See how it just comes off in little itty bitty chips there? If I have to do that down the entire coach to get rid of this, it's going to be a pain. I don't know how to get this stuff off. It's like an early wrap or MacTac or something. I don't know what it is. Wallpaper. I've tried sanding it off too, but I don't want to have to sand the entire length. That's going to be a giant pain as well. But I think I'm going to call it here on this video. We've done a lot of paint in this video, and my learning curve is pretty steep on the whole thing, but I think it's time to move on to the next segment, because then I can go on to the paint again. But check out that rim, eh? Just got that off Marketplace. Pretty happy with that. And it even looks pretty cool with stuck another piece of the wrap there, just to see the contrast, of course. That looks pretty cool. Looking forward to using those. You see the silver bar here? That's connected to a perimeter frame that goes around the coach. And it's, unfortunately, really toast. You can see a piece of it there on the other side. See how it's got no bottom on it? All the way down, it's just kind of disintegrating. The outriggers are fine, but the perimeter frame is toast. So I think we're gonna get into replacing that. And that's kind of why I also don't want to install any of the rear glass or the front glass yet, because I'm going to have loads of welding going around the inside, so I don't want to ruin that glass that I paid a lot of money for. So anyway, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more, subscribe. And I think you're going to want to be here for the next video, so hit what's that button called with the bell on it? Notification button. Because we're going to put the Duramax in it. We got to figure out how to get crane it in or crane it up, because that motor's pretty far recessed into this coach, so I have to build to probably spin the RV around and then get the farmer over here with his tractor and build an arm and scoop this one out and push the new one in and then build all the new mounts and then get the new tranny drive line. And I also have a whole new rear axle for this one. But I'm thinking with this old 350 here, let's do a will it run video. I have never put power to this thing to see if it'll work or not. So let's see if we can turn this thing over and fire it up. The old battery was actually underneath the step here, still in there. So not that I think that's gonna work at all, but yeah, let's see if that engine will work. And then if it does work, I still don't know what to do with it, quite honestly. So hope you're liking these videos as much as I like making them, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks very much for watching.